So all of you, please look at your book and you want my book, anyone? Open to the poem, The Laburnum Top. Let's start with that. Right, it's a very short poem. Hopefully we'll be completing it today. This poem, as the name suggests, it's about a laburnum top. Laburnum top is a tree. You know, something similar to, like in our Indian context, if we take it, it is similar to the Amaldas tree. You know what an Amaldas tree looks like? With its yellow flowers it has, you know, and it flowers for a very short time. And it sheds flowers also within, you can say, a couple of weeks. Right, so yellow flowers and the trees are covered with this yellow flowers, right? Beautiful tree it is. And during that time, we also see another tree which is, you know, like flowering. Have you heard of the Gulmohar tree? Yes, and Gulmohar tree has red flowers? Yes. So this Amaltas, the cassia tree, it has these yellow flowers, right? And, right, so this poem, you know, if we can relate it to the Indian context, yes, so this laburnum tree, it can be compared to the Amaltas. Laburnum top, the top of the tree, that is the branches of the tree, right? So we have the trunk of the tree and we have the branches of the tree. This poem is also about a bird, right? And the bird here is goldfinch. The setting of this poem is autumn. And it is in the afternoon. And it seems at that time there is golden sunlight, you know, like falling. And the tree is there of this beautiful yellow color. The goldfinch coming, it also has a yellow color. So, right, so we see this whole predominant color is yellow, right? And it's a little bird. And how do you think this bird can bring life to the tree? How can a little bird bring a tree alive? Before the arrival of the bird, this tree was silent, still. The little bird came and all of a sudden it seemed as if this tree has come alive, right? So we're going to find out how, okay? Yes, all of you look at your books and those of you at home can look at the screen. So although I think so, we should have some kind of a system where I can share the screen with students here. Because at home, people can always find their books. Yeah. Okay. The laburnum top is silent, quite still. In the afternoon, yellow September sunlight. A few leaves yellowing, all its seeds fallen, till the goldfinch comes with a twitching chirrup, a suddenness, a startlement at a branch end. Then sleek as a lizard and alert and abrupt, it she enters the thickness and a machine starts up. Of chitterings and of tremor of wings and trillings. The whole tree trembles and thrills. It is the engine of her family. She stokes it full, then flirts out to a branch end, showing her barred face identity mask. Then with eerie, delicate whistle chirrup whisperings, she launches away towards the infinite and the laburnum subsides to empty. What do you think has happened in this poem? Yes? Bird aaya tree pe baitha fir wapas gaya. Beech mein tree alive ho gaya. What is there that made this goldfinch come to this particular tree only? उसको अच्छा लगे वो ट्री येलो कलर द बर्ड लाइक्स इट्स अ फेवरेट कलर इज इट बिकॉज द बर्ड इज येलो एंड द ट्री इज येलो सो येलो येलो ओके सो इट्स कमिंग देयर व्हाट वहां पे इंसेक्ट्स होंगे ओके लुक एट हियर लुक एट द सेंटेंसेस ओवर हियर Read the lines once again here. She enters a thickness and a machine starts up. Of chitterings and of tremor of wings and trillings. What does she start? A machine starts up. What do you think is there in this particular tree? Why did this little bird come to this particular tree? The nest is there where her young ones are. Okay, that is why this little bird has come. And when we talk about September here, it is talking about the autumn months, right? So here we don't have a very demarcated autumn. You know, it is like all of a sudden, you know, like we just graduate into a very sharp or you can say cold winter, right? So what are the signs that nature shows that autumn is there around us? The leaves, the flowers shedding, yes, right? And of course, all of a sudden, you know, it seems as if all the leaves have fallen from the trees. And what beautiful colors they change. From a green to an orange to a brown, isn't it? Yes, right? So all these are there, you know, look at the colors which are there in the poem. We have the yellow of the laburnum tree. We have the golden yellow of the goldfinch. We have the tree also shedding its leaves. The seeds are they ripened, right? And if you look at these trees, so they have this long pods, you know, legumes just getting these pods are there on this tree, right? So all that here, what is there like? And in the afternoon sunlight, the sunlight falling in that golden column. So we have a predominant color in this poem throughout, that is the yellow color, right? One is the tree, you can say the bird comes, sits on the branches of the tree. There's a lot of noise, lot of movement. And there is this tremor, the shaking of the branches. Everything comes alive. What makes it come alive? The goldfinch, when she comes, the young ones, when they see their mother, you know, like they get so excited, making so much noise. She's come to feed them. And then after they are fed, she is also quite happy, quite satisfied. She comes and sits at the end of the branch of the tree. And once again, she flies away towards the infinite sky. And what happens to the tree? It is once again silent. Like it was in the beginning of the poem. Have you got an idea what this poem is about? Yes. So it's a very short poem. It's about the arrival of this bird. Now let us do it. You can say, let us do the paraphrasing of it. The laburnum top is silent, quite still. What is the laburnum top? The tree, the top. Top refers to the branches and the leaves. Flowers, right? Yes. Is silent, quite still. The silence, no activity at all, right? In the afternoon, yellow September sunlight. What time of the day is it? Afternoon. What month is it? September. And of course, when we talk about the season, it is also the beginning of the autumn season, right? So in the afternoon, yellow September sunlight. What is happening to the tree? A few leaves yellowing. The leaves are changing its color, right? Why? Because of the change of season. And of, yes, all its seeds fallen. Seeds have also fallen, right? Till the goldfinch comes. Everything is silent, quite still. Kab tak? Till the goldfinch does not come. What is a goldfinch? What's a goldfinch? It's a bird. It's a small bird. And what is very striking about it, that it has these golden, or you can see the yellow stripes on its wings, right? And, you know, like some birds and some insects, they also, you know, like they prefer, or rather they merge into the background of their surroundings also. Same color almost. Have you heard about that? Camouflage and all, isn't it, right? Yes. So here it is, the yellow tree and the yellow goldfinch. Maybe, yes, it is because, right, it's able to hide over there, keep its nest away from the bigger birds, right? So things there, because in that yellow color, the bird will also not be visible of the flowers there. But now the seeds are there, the leaves are also falling. Till the goldfinch comes with a twitching chirrup. What is a chirrup? The sound that the bird makes. Now, in this poem, we are going to read about sound words. We are going to read about words that show movement. Okay? So, the bird making that twitching, chirruping sound. Chirrups. The bird making that noise. Right? A suddenness, a startlement at a branch end. All of a sudden, the silence of that tree is disturbed. Who disturbs it? The bird, the goldfinch disturbs it. A suddenness. Suddenness means, yeah, all of a sudden, right? In seconds, you know, this activity starts. A startlement at a branch end. All of a sudden from the sky, the bird comes and sits at the end of the branch, right? And with the arrival of the bird starts a lot of activity. Can you identify the device over here? Look at your poem. Look at this line. A suddenness, a startlement. What is the literary device here? Now I'll assess you. 1 out of 10. The person who gives you the answer gets 10 out of 10. Let's see. What is the device over here? Suddenness, startlement, repetition of a consonant sound. What do we call it? Very nice. Can't you speak up louder and can't you tell me before? Yes. A suddenness, a startlement. Okay, so we can say, right? Sorry, that sir sound is repeated. That a sound is also there. A hum kya repeat kehte usko? Vowel sound ko assonance. But it is here, predominating sound is that, the consonant. A suddenness, a startlement at a branch end. What do we call a repetition of a consonant sound? Deepak, stand up, please let me know. Deepak, what do we call a consonant sound repetition? How do you spell alliteration? I-T-A-L-L-I-T-I-T. You missed something? E-R-A-T-I-O-N. Very good. Very nice. Okay, good. And of course here, then sleek as a lizard and alert and abrupt. Once again, yes. What is this? Sleek as a lizard. Who's going to tell me? Simile. What is sleek as a lizard? What is sleek as a lizard? The bird, right? And what does sleek mean? When the lizard moves around, you know, like, of course, does it create a lot of noise? Does it create a lot of disturbance? Very softly, very quickly. As sleek as a lizard, right? Without making so much of noise, without creating so much of disturbance, right? So all of a sudden it's come, sat on the branch end, and quickly, you won't even notice how quickly, right? So it is a simile over here. And it has gone there. And alert and abrupt. What is the device over here? Is it a consonant or is it vowel sound? So what do we call repetition of vowel sound? Assonance, right? Very nice. A-S-S-O-N-A-N-C-E. Do you remember? Yes, very good if you do. She enters the thickness. Who is she over here? Which bird? The goldfinch. She enters the thickness. What is the thickness? The thickness is the laburnum top, the branches, the leaves, right? And why has she come to this particular tree? Because her young ones are there. Her nest is there, right? And a machine starts up. It seems when she has come. And what is the sound when a machine starts up? Noise. Oh, I don't want you to make that sound, but you do understand, isn't it? Right? So when a machine starts up, yeah, a lot of noise happens, isn't it? Right? So yes, a machine starts up. And what are the sounds? Of chitterings and of tremor of wings and trillings. I mean, Mrs. Sound words kaun se ho sakte, movement kaun se ho sakte? Chitterings, sound, right? The chittering. Tremor, the movement of wings. Quick movement. So tremor is, we could feel the tremors after the earthquake, the shake, movement, right? Trillings. The sweet sounds or the sounds made by the birds. Please now tell me which are the sound words over here. Chittering is a sound word. Tremor is a movement word. Trilling is once again sound word. Very good. The whole tree trembles and thrills. And as a result of that, just imagine a tiny bird coming and creating so much of noise. As a result of it, it seems the whole tree is trembling, right? It's moving because of that. And thrill, that excitement, okay? It is the engine of her family. What is the engine of her family? Are the birds, the little ones, the engine, or is the goldfinch the engine? The birds? How? It is the engine of her family. So, uski family ka engine. Who started that engine? The goldfinch. And how do we keep the engine, you know, like, or how would you keep a machine running? There has to be constant fuel. So who's supplying that fuel? The goldfinches, they're coming and feeding, right? So it is the engine of a family. What is the engine of a family? The little ones, as they come to water, you can see how they become alert as they become awake. What is the device over here? It is the engine of a family. Is it a simile or is it a metaphor? Metaphor, very right, okay? She stokes it full. What does stoke mean? What are the things that they're like for an engine? You have to keep on adding fuel to it so that it keeps on running, isn't it? So she stokes it full, then flirts out to a branch end. After a family is full, fed, then the noise also subsides, right? All the excitement that they had in seeing their mother, it has calmed down. Then what does the little bird do? She comes and sits out at the end of the branch, right? Then flirts out to a branch end, showing her barred face identity mask. That time she comes and sits. Otherwise, earlier it was all of a sudden from the, you know, like a blue sky, this little bird came and just entered the thickness of the tree and started creating this noise and commotion. Now, after a family is fed and quiet and satisfied, she comes and sits out at the end of the branch. And she shows her face, her barred face identity mask. It could be, yeah, the identity that she has these stripes on her face. Yes, you, what's your name? Ayush, where's your mask? And what are you discussing right now? Something very important? Can I see a book? Can I see a book? Where are we reading? Can you explain it is the engine of her family? Can you explain this line to me and to your class? Can you explain it? Stand up, please. Why? You don't know English? Then speak in English. After wearing a mask properly, then speak. English is over. End of quantity. Balance is over. Yes, Dipanshu. Stand up, please. It is the engine of a family. Explain it to me. Sit down. Okay, very nice, very nice. Sit down, sit down. Yes, anybody else? No, Kunal, say don't ask me even. Right? So it is the engine of a family. What has happened here? The little bird has come. It's made so much of noise. And yes, here, everything has come to life. Yeah, and it has come to life. And right, the little birds there, they have to be constantly, regularly fed so that her family keeps on what? Stays alive. Right? So the little birds need to be fed regularly. So that is what the mother is doing. That is what the little goldfinch is doing. Showing a barred face identity mask. Then with eerie, delicate whistle chirrup whisperings, she launches away towards infinite and the laburnum subsides to empty. So the bird comes, sits at the end of the branch of the tree. She shows her identity. Or she does not show it. That is, once again, a barred face identity mask. Whether it is that she's hiding behind the branches of the tree, or yes, she's revealing her striped face. And then afterwards, when she is happy, she's satisfied that her family is there, content. What does the little bird do? Making that eerie, making that strange whispering sound once again. The little bird flies again towards the infinite. What's infinite here? The sky. And the laburnum subsides to empty. Subside means settle down. Once again, what has happened to the laburnum tree? Is it noisy? Is it silent? Like it was in the beginning. And who came here and created all this noise and mischief? Just like a naughty student coming to the class, creating a lot of noise and disturbing everyone and then going out again. Isn't it? But mother is there, of course. She's doing her duty. She's there coming to feed her little ones. And when she's happy, she's satisfied, she flies away once again. And of course, she'll come back again in due time. Okay? Right? Yes, any doubts, any questions, anyone? Any doubts? No, ma'am, we never have any doubts. Oh, really? I would love it if you people give a response. Okay? You're not muted now. Although sometimes I do wish ye mute ka option hona chahiye yahan pe. Right? But this is what makes the class so, I would say, lively and nice when I get responses from you. Yeah, and you are there. Look at them. Some of you are so happy to be with your friends that you just can't control yourself from talking. Again and again, I think so every teacher is reminding you, fine, we're happy to see you back with your friends. It's nice. You needed to come out because it's very, very, I would say, depressing, you know, being confined at home for so long. Right? But don't be too excited also. that you end up creating problems for yourself and for others also. Right? So you are responsible. You are sensible. Right? So you are going to behave responsibly. Okay? Yes, those of you who have done King Tut's question, are most welcome to send me a notebook. I'll check it and return to you. And of course, here, once again, some students are asking. So you can. Okay? Right? The period is also about to end. You will bring this book only tomorrow. I'll discuss the questions and then I'll come to the writing skills. Tomorrow, one day, we'll do writing skills. Then we're going to start with the other book. Okay? Right? Do you want extracts? Do you want homework?
No.
Why not? Ma'am, I'm lazy. Ho gaye hain. Hum certified lazy hain. Is it? Very bad. Dheere dheere aaoge track pe. Aa jaana track pe. Any doubts, anyone? Any questions? Yes, students at home.